Suriname heeft op donderdag 4 maart 2021 een partij medische spullen in ontvangst genomen. Dit in het kader van het helpen bestrijden van de COVID-19-pandemie. De donatie is afkomstig van Frankrijk. Ambassadeur Antoine Joly heeft aan de ministers Albert Ramdin van Buitenlandse Zaken, International Business en Internationale Samenwerking en Amar Ramadin van Volksgezondheid symbolisch deze overhandiging gepleegd.
We can focus on a cooperation that is sometimes unseen. We do not dare speak about it often. It is the health care we give to the Surinamese in our services all along the border. The Hospital of Saint Laurent, quite half of the clients of the hospital are Surinamese. Well, a lot of them are residents, but few of them are not. And it's the same with the centers we have in Apatou or in Grand Santi or in Maripasoula. So we do that. We welcome also the children for schools, and we welcome the Surinamese that need care and that go to our hospital. We don't speak a lot about that because it's in the margin of the legal framework of health in France, but we do it, and we know we have to do it because of the history of the region. And as I often say, we don't share only a border, but we share a population. And the history gave us this heritage we have to care about. So that's the first point I wanted to tell you and to focus on that, because it will have also consequences in the vaccination of the population. The second point I wanted to tell you, just to respond to what you said about the vaccination for all. My president is very involved in fighting for that. France chose to help COVAX, France and the EU. And we are part of the policy of EU in the vaccination of the world. And as far as now, EU is about half of the financing of the COVAX. COVAX is anonymous, I would say. That is to say that France is not instrumentating the way we are helping the vaccination of the world. Well, it might be also something that we can think about, but that's true that we are helping a lot COVAX.
Het is een overhandiging van medisch equipment en PPE. Aan, vanuit de Franse zijde, dus de Franse regering, in dit geval Frans-Guyana. En we hebben vandaag een overhandiging gehad. Dus ik ben nog niet helemaal geïnformeerd over de details, over de inhoud. Maar het is wel zo dat er wat equipment bij zit, personal protective equipment en medisch apparatuur in de bestrijding, in de strijd tegen COVID-19. En dat hebben wij zeer warm ontvangen. En we kijken uit naar de echte ontvangst van de spullen, zodat we die kunnen dirigeren naar waar het nodig mocht zijn. Alhoewel wij in een goede positie zitten qua COVID-19. We hebben nu een hele gunstige situatie. We zijn bijna, kan je zeggen, uit die tweede golf. We zitten nu vrij stabiel. Is het wel nodig om nog steeds de maatregelen acht te nemen? En ook het personeel, welke nog steeds werkt in de ziekenhuizen en de frontlinie, dat de mensen ook beschermd hun werk kunnen doen. Want je weet niet als iemand in een incubatieperiode zit en opgenomen is, en, of op de SIH, of maakt niet uit waar. Mensen moeten steeds weer beschermd kunnen werken, en die garantie kunnen we bieden doordat we genoeg PPE in voorraad moeten hebben.
It's part of the strategic cooperation that exists between the two countries, Suriname and France, French Guiana. We both are impacted by the COVID-19 throughout the world, but as neighbors even more, especially where we have so much interaction on the border, in the border area. And I think this handover symbolizes more than just handing over PPE. It's a symbol of good cooperation, better cooperation, I believe I would say. And your ambassador is a very good advocate for France, but also for Suriname. So thank you very much for that. It is important for us to receive this in the context of mitigating the impact of COVID-19. Of course, the best thing is that once it is properly managed, that we can continue with our lives as before, as best as possible. I'm sure it won't be the same ever again. But it's an opportunity to make, you know, good of it, and to make sure that we understand globally, but especially in relationships, that whatever happens here will impact you, whatever happens there will impact us. And so it's a mutually beneficial arrangement to support each other as much as possible.